Hello everybody, this is Dimple here welcoming you all back to my next tutorial on Android framework components. So in today's tutorial we will see what are the different methods to collect logs from our Android device and how to analyze them. As a developer, if I want to fix any particular issue, I depend on logs. So all my debugging has to be done through logs. Without logs, I cannot proceed further and root cause the issue. Logs play a very crucial role in debugging and fixing a particular issue. So we'll see what are the different various methods to collect logs. The first one is through ADB. So through ADB, I will collect the logs now. ADB logcat command. So I've connected my device. And I'll just execute ADB logcat. And I start getting the logs. Y'all can see what exactly is happening on my device. So what is clicked, what's happening. So this is a large chunk of data will be coming at a time. So it is always better to output all this to a particular file. So I can use ADB logcat log dot text file and I can start reproducing my issue. Whatever is my issue, I have to start reproducing now. Now, whatever the issue is there, that logs related to that particular issue will be outputted in this log dot text file. Thanks to Android, Android has very good logging capabilities. It adds many logs so that we come to know what exactly is happening in which module. Now I'll open log.txt. So once I finish reproducing, I can click on Ctrl C and my log.txt will be created. So here we can see the log.txt file. And I can choose the language as Android Logger and we can see what exactly is happening in our device. For now, we will not have any particular information because I didn't do much. I just unlocked my device, so we'll not find any much particular information. So this is one of the way. Another method, whichever I showed, if you want the time and the date of the issue reproduction, always if we know the time and the date when the issue occurred on our device, we can always easily identify and root cause the issue because there will be large chunk of data. If we know the exact time we can map to, it will be easy. For that we can use this command ADB logcat minus v thread time and output to a particular file. So this will give us the time and date at which the particular issue has happened. Okay, this was the first way using ADB. The second way is you can install Android Logger plugin in your notepad and you can start collecting the logs. So if you click on this Android icon, you start getting the logs, whatever I'm typing or whatever I'm doing, which app I open, everything will be logged here. And if I want to stop, I can click on this again and it will be exited. So this is the second way of collecting the logs. Third way, we can collect logs and we can analyze and root cause the issue through Android Studio. So here I've created one application, a very small application, which will divide the two numbers. So I will run this. So let me run this application on my emulator. It will just display a toast message of the result. So here we go. Our app is installed successfully. App name is log example. And we can see the toast message. Result is 1. And here is our logcat. So how to go to logcat through here? You can go to view, two tool windows and you can select log cat here. So you can see the logs here also. Live logs you can see. Now I will introduce a bug here. Let me try to divide by zero where I'll get an error. And we try to run this again. And you all can see our application has stopped because we have divide by zero error. I'll click to open here and I'll delete the old logs and start collecting the logs again. So here I can see the log message. So here we can see there is a fatal exception. There is Android runtime fatal exception and the process ID is 30840. And we can see the exception in this particular line caused by Java language arithmetic exception divide by zero error. And it is showing me the line. So if I click on that, it will take me to the line where the issue is. So by this, from this log analysis, I came to know where exactly is my issue is. So this was a small example, but if we have huge thousands of lines of code, then the log cat will tell us where exactly the issue is. In those cases, it will be very, very helpful. So as an Android developer, the debugging skills is very, very essential to root cause and fix an issue. So we saw what are the different types of collecting the logs. Logs are very important. Okay, so we saw through ADB, we saw through Notepad, and also we saw through Android Studio. That was all I wanted to tell today in this tutorial. Thanks everyone for watching. We'll meet in our next tutorial. Until then, take care. Bye.